The dosage is, depending on how you use it and the substance, the type, there's Lugols, which has been around for 150 years, which is now at a lower concentration in the United States because of certain laws that were passed. But you can get 2% iodine, Lugol's iodine, you can get 7%, and you could even get as high as 15%. Whenever you use iodine, no matter what iodine you use, transdermally painting the skin, you have to be a little sensitive. Sometimes it can burn the skin. Most often it doesn't, but you have to watch for skin reactions, drying out of the skin. I recommend for women with breast cancer to paint their breasts with iodine. Oral dosages vary depending on where you live, your age, your size. Today in the Northern Hemisphere, we do have a problem with radioactive iodine. If your thyroid is empty, running deficient on iodine, it will be a sponge for the radioactive type. So it is really important today to supplement with iodine. It's essential. If you live in the interior, away from the sea, also very important. You'll have less iodine, exposed to less iodine in the environment. With a nascent iodine I recommend, which is in the atomic form, which is the form that the thyroid needs to create the thyroid hormones. It doesn't have to break down a molecular iodine, which is Lugol's, or the pill forms, solid forms of iodine. With the nascent iodine, in the bottle it says three to five drops, I believe, three times a day. For my three-year-old, I've given up 15 to 20 drops at a time. You can take iodine, start out with, say with a child, if you're getting an infection, instead of an antibiotic, the iodine is always going to be safer than an antibiotic. Iodine will not destroy and kill the healthy bacteria in the intestines. The only reaction normally is a detoxification if a person is very, very toxic and very, very deficient. So with children, basically for basic supplementation, at a minimum level in Northern Hemisphere today, I probably would be talking about 30 drops a day of nascent. Depending on Lugol's, maybe the same. Some Lugol's, as I say, depending on the concentration, you'd be taking less Lugol's than nascent iodine. In treatment of cancer, patients usually go for 25 milligrams up to 50 and as high as 100 milligrams a day. This is what these iodine doctors are suggesting. 100 years ago, the doctors used to go even higher, much higher actually, so we're still in a very comfortable range. With children, I would not hesitate when a child has a high fever and has an infection to do 10 or 15 drops of nascent every 2 or 3 hours. The more you break up the dosage, the more you can actually take orally in a very comfortable way for the body. When in the cancer protocol, we're talking about dosing with all the different items every 2 or 3 hours.